Previously on Roz.
There's a bullet hole in the dress. I'm telling you, the girl was shot.
Thank you, Sharon. Your work is done now. We'll take it from here.
North.
You can't talk to anyone about this.
Oh my God, you told her. You have to promise me that you are not gonna flip out. Hey, it's me.
What do you make of that, Mark?
The photo was marked 1959.
So with this picture, what we're seeing is there's more of us?
Different.
I'm gonna find out what the truth is. You can count on it.
September 27th. I'm Liz Parker, and I'll never look at the stars in the sky the same way again. I'll never look at anything the same way again. What did Max Evans mean when he said, "I'll see you in school"? Was it, "I won't be able to breathe until we meet again"? Or was it just something someone says to, like, fill space? And what is he thinking right now? Is he also obsessed, tortured, going from one sleepless night to the next, wondering what's gonna happen between us?
Sleep. Hey, I was sleeping.
Amazing.
What's amazing?
That you can sleep when the key to our entire existence is out there.
Michael.
Max, listen. That picture Valente showed Liz, it means there's someone else out there. Someone who was here in 1959. That means he was here when it crashed. He knows where we come from. He knows who we are. He knows why we're here. Maybe he knows how we get back.
Michael, I know how you feel. Believe me. I want to know, too. But the sheriff has that picture, so we'll never see it. I mean, that would be impossible, right? Michael?
know about these people? Nothing. How do we know that they're not 3 feet tall, green, and slimy?
I guess we don't.
And you know what else doesn't, like, particularly please me? These powers. How do we know they can't just, like, wiggle their noses and, like, poof us into an oblivion?
I guess we don't.
Okay, you are being, like, so casual about this. I want to choke you. Liz, we are dealing with aliens. Oh.
Can you please not say that word in public?
The point is, we don't know anything about these Czechoslovakians. Are they good Czechoslovakians? Bad Czechoslovakians? We don't know. They're just random Czechoslovakians. For all we know, they don't have their passport.
Who's Czechoslovakian?
Hey!
Hey. So who's Czechoslovakian?
The guy in the hardware store.
The new kid at school who works at the hardware store.
Exactly.
Oh. What about him?
Nothing.
Fantastic.
Czechoslovakia, 9 o'clock. Okay, that guy creeps me out.
Really close up. The thing about Czechoslovakians that you have to sort of factor in is they have these incredibly soulful eyes.
That is totally not Mr. Singer.
Wow.
Hi, I'm Kathleen Topolsky. I'll be substituting for Mr. Singer, who's out sick for a few days.
I hope he's seriously ill.
Infamous Roswell, New Mexico. Before we get down to work, let me just ask. Does anyone here actually believe in aliens? Okay, let's take roll. Bartley.
Here.
Collins.
Here.
Evans.
Here.
Garen. Michael Garen, is he here today? Does anyone know where Michael is? Evans, right? Max Evans.
Yeah.
Do you know where Michael Garen is?
Michael's not really into geometry.
He's not into it. I guess I can understand that. Pretty and inspiring stuff. So, let's open our books to page 228. Hi.
Hi. How's it going?
Good. You know, things are just normal, you know? Completely normal.
Good.
Weird.
What?
That substitute just asked all of those questions about Michael. You know, what was that about?
She was just taking attendance.
Right.
Please don't worry about it. No one's suspicious of Michael. It's me.
Good morning.
Morning. Who is that?
FBI agent Hart.
Who's he here to talk to?
No one, far as I can tell.
What's he doing here?
Doesn't appear to be doing anything. He's been sitting there since 7 a.m.
Deputy Hanson, did you ask him what he's doing here?
Yes, sir. He said that he was here on assignment and that we should go about our business as usual.
Huh. So, your response to that was just to... All right.
Agent Hart, I'm Sheriff Valenti. Can I see some identification, please?
Sorry about the intrusion. I'm here on assignment, Sheriff. You should just go about business.
As usual. Yeah, I heard. See, my problem with that is that having a federal agent sitting smack dab in the middle of my station house isn't exactly business as usual.
My orders are not to leave this chair until I'm relieved.
Agent Hart, the FBI has no jurisdiction here. Now, I'm going to ask you to please get up and leave and take your folding chair with you.
It's impossible, right, that she's not who she says she is.
Right. Well, no one is who they say they are, but, I mean, what do you mean exactly? Forget it. What, that she's a spy?
No, don't be ridiculous.
Because that kind of stuff happens, you know.
Now you're being crazy.
No, come on. We'll think about it. Okay. She takes attendance. What substitute teacher takes attendance? I mean, God, the whole thing is so Roswellian. I'm telling you, Liz, she's been sent here.
Why would she be sent here?
To find the Czechoslovakians.
Sniff some cedar oil, Maria.
Which makes me feel that much more about what I already thought before you told me about this, which is that we should definitely, definitely, definitely tell Alex.
No, look, Maria, we mustn't tell anyone, ever, ever.
Mustn't? When have you ever said mustn't? Look, we need someone with a little perspective, okay? There's all this stuff happening, and it's dangerous. The other day, the sheriff asked me all these questions, and now with this Topolsky person poking around. You know, that's what they do. They send in special government task forces, alien hunters, okay? And suddenly, we're like accessories to Czechoslovakians. We need Alex in on this.
Just do it. I don't know.
Admittedly, he's not James Bond, but he's all we've got right now.
Oh, so now I'm a freak?
Once he headed this way.
Like in this general direction or like towards me?
Like the ladder.
Oh, God.
What are you gonna say?
I don't even know if there's anything to say. I mean, I saw him over the summer and it was casual. I am sure now that we're back in school, he's just thinking of me as a summer thing.
Liz.
Kyle.
That was my girl.
See ya.
Hey.
Hey. How's it going?
Good, you know, I'm just pretty loaded down with all the school stuff.
Yeah, I know, you take all that stuff pretty seriously.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right.
Listen, Liz, I think it's important that we're honest with each other. I was talking to Tommy Hoag on the team and he agrees with me. A person should be on time, Liz. I know we've left things casual, and I understand that, but you did say that you would meet me at the Crash Festival, and I just feel that if you care about a person, which I do, then you should be on time. The truth is, if you were just some girl and you stiffed me on a date, I'd walk in a second. You're not.
Kyle, I really want to talk to you right now. I do, but it's just not a good time. I'm sorry. I gotta go. I'm sorry. About Parker.
Liz.
Yeah. Photographic memory. Wow, that's interesting. I've never met anybody with a photographic memory before.
Helps in my line of work.
Here,
Let me help you with those. Looking for Michael? Garen? Maybe I made a mistake.
Mickey! Sure, it was my records. It was definitely my records.
Yeah.
She asked about me in class?
Oh, well, she was just taking attendance, and so when you weren't there, she asked the class if anyone knew you.
So she's looking for me.
I don't know what's going on, Michael. I just thought I should tell you.
Thanks.
Sure.
Listen, if Hank insulted you or anything...
Oh, no, no.
Kind of have to ignore him.
Sorry to just show up here.
It's where I live. Thanks.
Yeah, I know it's late, but he sent an agent into my building. I think I've got a right to an immediate explanation. No, I won't call back. No, tomorrow is not acceptable. Yeah, I'm sorry about it, too. Listen, excuse me. Hello? Hello?
Good evening, Deputy. I'm selling candies for charity.
Charity?
Yeah. I'm on the committee to reopen Westlake Orphanage. Deputy Hanson, you can be a part of helping to find homes for dozens of children in need. Single boxes are $6 a piece, and I feel obliged to strongly recommend the peanut clusters. They are good.
Well, I'm kind of trying to lay out the sweets right now.
Understood, Deputy. If it's all right, I'll just take a look and see who else is around.
There's nobody at that corridor.
What if I came back tomorrow night?
Well, it's usually pretty empty at night.
Well, thanks for your help, Deputy. What are you doing here? I'm selling candies for charity. Not in here, you're not. Yes, sir.
Are you insane?
I didn't just wander in, all right? I had a cover story.
And what was your cover story?
Selling candies for charity. Peanut cluster?
And they bought it?
No, they all seem to be on a diet.
Not the candy, Einstein, the story.
Yeah, they bought the story. Why are you wearing that?
Because, Michael, I have a date with a guy that I like. In fact, I like my whole life here. In fact, I have a date next Friday that I'm hoping I won't have to miss because I'm running from the law.
You two, the point is this.
That file has got to be in Valente's office.
All right, he leaves for the day at 7:30. There's no one else in the entire wing of the sheriff's station. We go in, we find the file, we get the info, we put the file back.
So how do we break in, hypothetically?
The window, it's got a lock on it. It's nothing you can't handle.
Alarm system? Hypothetically.
Piece of cake. Even I could deactivate it.
Max, don't humor him, okay? I can't believe you're even considering this.
I just want to know how feasible the plan is. Which it's not. Feasible. It's not feasible, Mike.
This is what we've been waiting for our entire lives. I mean, this is the first time we've ever had any clue that might tell us who we are. We don't have a choice.
Hey! Anybody here?
And with government agents after us, we ought to get our asses in gear, don't you think?
Agents?
What are you talking about?
Talk to Liz.
Anybody hungry?
Hey, guys! We got pizza!
Hey, honey, you look pretty.
Michael, hi.
Hey, I was just leaving.
We got plenty of pizza.
My dad's cooking.
Thanks.
Well, I'm starved. Come on, guys.
Plates, napkins, let's eat.
So we know that the sum of A, B, and C equals 360 degrees.
What's she talking?
Miss Parker?
180.
I'm sorry.
It's a triangle. You know, the sum of the parts would be 180 degrees.
Right. Right, of course. Equals 180 degrees.
But she pulled other students' records.
Well, yeah, but the point is she pulled Michael's.
Well, how many others were there?
I don't know, maybe 10?
Well, 10's a lot.
Okay, it might have only been 5. I'm not sure how many there were.
You can't just show up at Michael's and get him riled up like that. You don't know him. He's not big into let's go over our options. He acts on things.
I'm sorry, I just thought that Michael was in danger and that I better tell him.
In danger of what?
I don't know, I have no idea. Look, I am just saying that if there is a spy among us, don't you think it behooves us to do something about it?
Spy?
Well, yeah,
Liz,
no, with Max, that sort of thing exists, doesn't it? There's like special branches of the government. Alien hunters, you know, that sort of thing.
So you think Miss Topolsky is an alien hunter?
When you say it like that, it sounds ridiculous.
Liz, thank you, you know, for looking out for us. But we have to go on with life as it was before this happened. And we have to be careful now. All of us. You too.
the eraser room, huh?
Liz, do you know what the second floor eraser room means?
Of course I know what it means. What does it mean?
It's where Greg Coleman gave Marlene Garcia that hickey the size of a softball. It's where Richie Rule and Amanda Lourdes consummated everything.
Okay, Maria, you know what?
You're just making this into something that it's not.
Liz, I don't think you should do this, okay? I mean, we don't know what can happen. I mean, the guy touched you and you saw into his soul. How do we know what happens if he kisses you? How do we know what it is to be kissed by a Czechoslovakian? You don't.
Okay, Maria, no one is kissing anyone here. I mean, Max isn't even the least bit interested in me, you know? He said that things were just like they used to be before. Nothing's changed. He said that.
Oh, my God. It's not just kissing that goes on in the eraser room, Liz.
She's got that right.
The eraser room does two things. Claims erasers and takes our innocence. Do you know what I mean by takes our innocence, Liz? The eraser room has taken some of the best of us.
Afternoon, Sheriff. Agent Stevens. You don't write, you don't call. I'm sorry about kicking Junior out of here the other day, but he had no jurisdiction. No offense.
None taken.
So, what'd you guys find on that waitress uniform?
Well, several things. Actually, Sheriff, tomatoes, salt, water, sugar, vinegar. Ketchup, Sheriff, no blood. We've wasted enough taxpayer dollars on trying to find something that isn't out there. No spaceship landed here in 1947. No aliens are currently residing in Roswell, New Mexico. I've been given the authority by the governor to search the premises and remove any information pertaining to UFOs, alien sightings, and other alleged paranormal occurrences in this county. This thing is over, Sheriff. What's going on with it, guys?
Found blood on the dress. I mean, why else would you care enough to remove my files? Wouldn't that be a waste of taxpayer dollars?
It's locked.
This won't take long. Thank you, Sheriff.
I've never been here before.
I just thought we should be somewhere private.
Right.
You were right about Topolsky. She isn't who she appears to be.
How?
She's been using this office. We should find out why she's here.
Yeah.
She has off 6th and 7th period, so we might be here a while.
If you crash landed in 1947, are you really 16 or are you like 52 in a 16-year-old's body? Or do you guys just
age differently. I mean, it's like one alien year equal to 3 human years.
You've thought about this a lot, haven't you?
Kind of.
Well, we know we came out of the pods in 1989. We just don't know how long we were there. When we came out, we looked like 6-year-olds.
So were you like green?
Green?
Before you took human form, were you 3 feet tall and green and slimy? You know, I'm very sorry about asking you that. It's Maria's question.
No, we just always look like this. Except for the third eye. Kidding.
Yeah, I knew you were kidding. Such a jerk. So, you really have no idea where you're from, like what planet or who your people are besides Michael and Isabel.
No idea.
Well, that must be kind of freeing in a way.
Freeing?
Well, just with me, you know, my parents own the crash down, so everyone in town knows who I am. If I simply just get a haircut, everyone seems to notice, and they have to give me their opinion on it. It kind of makes life claustrophobic. It's like, you know, how am I ever supposed to become whoever it is that I'm gonna become while everyone's looking? You know? Sometimes I wish I could just be invisible.
Sometimes I wish I didn't have to be so invisible.
Talk to him?
I'll do it. Just check and make sure the address is correct.
Got it.
They're taking things out of the sheriff's office. What? I don't know, some guy in a suit, so we gotta get in there. It's now or never, Max.
You know, I'd steer you to this side of the menu. Oh, excuse me. Where have you been? I need you to cover when?
Tonight.
Oh, no, it's a zoo.
Excuse me. I've been waiting for my hot fudge blast off for like 20 minutes.
Yeah, like he needs 80 grams of fat.
Okay, so one trip to the eraser room and you're like above working?
Go get your uniform on, Madonna. The masses are demanding alien-themed greasy food, and by God, it is our job to serve it to them.
Okay, look, Maria, this is really important. I promise I will tell you everything later. You're the best, but right now, I've got to go.
Okay, I want some answers. All right, because first of all, there are rumors going around that last week you were shot here in the cafe. And then at the crash festival, you were seemingly run over by a car, but then you weren't. And every time I walk up to you two, you go silent or you make up some ridiculous story about Czechoslovakia, which is a country that has not existed for 10 years. So I want the truth, and I want it now.
Alex, the reason that we keep on changing subject is
cramps. We have cramps, Alex.
Yeah. And we didn't even want to talk about it in front of you because we thought that it would just make you feel really uncomfortable.
But if you really want to know, we can tell you.
In really excruciating detail.
No! I'm eating.
Thank you.
Michael, it's important to me, too.
All you want to do is protect what you got here in Roswell.
That's right, I do.
Did you ever think about what it's like here for me, Max?
Of course I have. Look, the woman who pulled your records, she's on the way to your place.
What?
Just stay away from there tonight. Isabella's waiting for you at our house. Just go there and wait.
Wait for her to come and find me.
Don't do anything stupid.
Liz!
Where you ended up, and Michael ended up here.
It's a long story.
Is his foster father always so
tough? Yeah.
Liz!
Kyle!
Hey, Max.
Hey, Kyle.
What's going on?
Nothing.
Why are you whispering?
We're just, waiting for Michael. We're gonna go,
bowl.
Why are you whispering?
We're going bowling.
Liz, what were you doing down there?
Oh, I dropped my ring.
Why are you whispering?
I'm gonna give you my number. And could you have Michael call me?
Bowling?
Liz.
What are you doing?
Okay, great. It's a date. No. It's not a date. It's a lunch.
Lunch. Right.
I better get home. AWOL. You know the guy doesn't know how to control his powers.
I know.
Thank you. get Michael out of there. I'll keep the money out of his office as long as I can.
Forget something? Papers.
Sheriff? I'm so glad someone's here. I have a flat tire, and I am so non-mechanical.
Sheriff. You're off duty, Sheriff. I'd be happy to help the young lady out.
It's okay, Deputy. I got it.
Michael, let's go now. Lenny's back.
Set, Miss Evans.
Thanks. Thanks a lot.
Isabel, right?
Yeah.
We got past curfew.
Well, I had a flat tire.
Right. Where's Max tonight?
Oh, I have no idea. I'm just his sister and housekeeper. Thanks again.
Sorry. About before. Maybe I don't really know what it's like for you.
The thing I've realized is the fact that my life basically sucks is a good thing. It's easier. You always have to be able to leave, pack a suitcase, go somewhere else. Maybe 10 years from now. Maybe a week from now. Maybe tomorrow. So my advice? Don't get in too deep, Maximilian. It only makes us weaker.
Garen?
Your friend Michael is in serious trouble. I'm not a substitute teacher. I saw you at Michael's house last night. I'm the new guidance counselor.
Guidance counselor.
And Michael is a boy who's in serious danger of being expelled from the school. If you're really a friend, you'll talk to him. And you'll have him come in and meet with me. Soon. Are you with me, Miss Parker?
I'll tell him.
Thank you.
Since I found out about Max and Michael and Isabel, I've been thinking a lot about secrets. That for everyone who has a secret, there's someone else who needs to know what that secret is. How sometimes secrets keep people from feeling like they belong. And sometimes secrets make you feel like you do belong.
I just want to feel safe in my own skin.
And now even I, Liz Parker, the smallest of small town girls with the simplest of lives,
happy again.
Even I have something to hide.